We have a last speech of this session. Faith-inspiring incidents in the propagation of Islam and Ahmadiyyat. Speech is in English by Mulana Mubarak Ahmed Nazir Sahib, Missionary, Canada. I request him to come and please deliver this speech.
أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله أما بعد فأعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم يا أيها الرسول بلغ ما أنزل إليك من ربك وَإِن لَّمْ تَفْعَلْ فَمَا بَلَّغْتَ رِسَالَةَ وَاللَّهُ يَعْصِمُكَ مِنَ النَّاسِ إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَا يَهْدِي الْقَوْمَ الْكَافِرِينَ ادْعُ إِلَى سَبِيلِ رَبِّكَ بِالْحِكْمَةِ وَالْمَوْعِظَةِ الْحَسَنَةِ وَجَادِلْهُم بِالَّتِي هِيَ أَحْسَنُ إن ربك هو أعلم بمن زل عن سبيله وهو أعلم بالمهتدين. O Messenger, convey to the people what has been revealed to thee from thy Lord. And if thou do not do this, it is as if you have not conveyed the message altogether. And Allah will protect you from men. Surely Allah does not guide the disbelieving people. Rasool achhi tarah pahuncha de jo tere rab ki taraf se teri taraf utara gaya hai aur agar tune aisa na kiya to goya tune is paigham ko nahi pahunchaya aur Allah tujhe logon se bachayega yaqinan Allah kafir qaum ko hidayat nahi deta. Aur dusri jo maine ayat padhi hai, the second verse which I have recited, the translation is, call unto the way of thy Lord with wisdom and goodly exhortation, and argue them in a way that is best. And surely thy Lord knows best who has strayed from his way, and he knows those who are rightly guided. Apne Rab ke raaste ki taraf hikmat ke saath aur achhi nasihat ke saath daawat dey. اور ان سے ایسی دلیل کے ساتھ بحث کر جو بہترین ہو. یقیناً تیرے رب ہی سے جو اس کے راستے سے بھٹک چکا ہے سب سے زیادہ جانتا ہے اور ہدایت والوں کا بھی سب سے زیادہ علم رکھتا ہے. My dear brothers and my dear sisters, my dear children, السلام علیکم. Look at the gigantic task before this small community. To convey the message to the entire world. Hazrat Masih Maud alayhi salatu wasalam was given that revelation. I shall cause thy message to reach the corners of the earth. And then Hazrat Masih Maud alayhi salatu wasalam said, every nation will drink of this fountain. And this movement will spread. And this movement will rapidly grow until it will finally encompass the entire world. Many tribulations and obstacles shall come, but God will remove them all. And He will fulfill His promise. And God addressed me saying, I shall grant thee blessings upon blessings, until kings shall seek blessing from thy garments. When we consider the task that is before us, And we consider our meager resources. We consider our small number. And we consider the prophecies that Allah Ta'ala has given to the promised Messiah. Which prophecy of Hazrat Masih Maud Salatu Wasalam was not fulfilled that we should ever doubt the fulfillment of this prophecy? 300 years would not pass when this prophecy, inshallah ta'ala, will be fulfilled.
Narae Takbir! Hazrat Muhammad Mustafa! Islam Ahmadiyyat! Islam Ahmadiyyat! Ghulam Ahmad ki! Narae Takbir!
We obviously get upset. Sometimes we become worried. Hazrat Masih Maud ne farmaya hai, dil nikal jata hai kabu se, ye mushkil soch kar. Kitna mushkil kaam hai. Ae mere jaan ki pana, fauje malaik ko utar. Let the angels of Allah appear on this world. And Hazrat Masih Maud alayhi salatu wasalam also received this revelation. Yansuruka rijalan nuhi ilayhi min as-samaa'i. That people will come and help you, God will reveal to them. You must have heard many of the Friday sermons of Hazur, in which he has explained many incidents where people will guided God the Almighty, the angels revealed to them. Some of them saw the photo of Hazrat Masih Maud alayhi salam. In the last Friday sermon, Hazur offered the janazah prayer for one Mr. Abu Bakr from Egypt, who saw the photo of Hazrat Masih Maud alayhi salatu wasalam on the MTA, and he looked and he said, "This is the photo I saw in my dream. This is the man I saw in my dream." So the angels, by the grace of Allah, are working. But we are upset. Hazrat Masih Maud alayhi salatu wasalam has also said, "Bamufti ajr nusrat rad hindat ay khi varna qadae asma asi bahar hal shivat paida." Oh my dear brothers, help me in this cause. This is a free gift. Because God the Almighty has ordained that this jamaat will prosper. This jamaat will grow and none dare retard its progress. I and my apostles will prevail. So my dear brothers and my dear, gigantic task. And the dawn is approaching. And the evening is approaching. And the clock is ticking. 300 years. Over 125 years have already passed. What are our responsibilities? I will say countless incidents. You open the books of Maulana Ghulam Raji Ki Sahib or Khadam Sahib of Gujarat or Mauli Abulata Sahib Jalandhari. You will see countless incidents. Which one should I narrate? How many should I narrate? What about Shammas Sahib? Jalaluddin Shammas. And there are many of our young missionaries as well. I thought, why not I should start an incident which happened in my life. Nowadays, traveling from Qadian to Africa, to Sierra Leone, would take up almost about a day. At the most, but I am talking of 1945. When I was about 11 years old, maybe 10, 11 years old, and Hazrat Musleh Maud ordered my father, Maulvi Nazir Ahmed Sahib Ali. I am hesitant to narrate some of the incidents directly connected with me or with my father. he was a missionary, that he should go to Sierra Leone. The money was not available, and he was to travel by ship and by open truck. So my father, my mother, and I traveled from Kadian and went to Sierra Leone. It took about 3 months. Not one day, not 2 days, 3 months. We had to go back by ship to Aden, and from Aden we had to go into the Red Sea, to the port of Sudan, and from Sudan we had to go in an open truck, which traveled for days and days and days, pushing many lorries, many trucks, sleeping in the Sahara Desert, sleeping on the sand, dirty water, red water, because of the red skin in which the water was contained. No hot food, surviving on old chapatis, bread. This is how we traveled and traveled and traveled until we reached a place called Fort Lamy in Chad. And from there we took a train and went to Lagos. And from Lagos, we were to travel to Freetown. During this journey, long travel, I became very sick. I was a little boy, and I became extremely sick. Probably I had this black water fever that you start urinating blood in your urine. But my father there was a ship that was available that was going from Lagos to Freetown. And it would take about 7 days. And in those days, the doctor would examine you before you go inside to see if you are fit for traveling. My father passed the medical test. My mother also passed the medical test. But when the doctor examined me, he said, "This boy cannot survive. He cannot survive for those 7 days of travel in the ship." And he told my father that we have doubts whether this boy will ever survive. We do not have a cold storage on the ship. We will only allow this boy to travel until you sign on this paper that if he dies, we will have to sink him into the sea. उन्होंने कहा कि यह बच्चा सफर नहीं कर सकता 7 दिन का, हमारे पास कोई कोल्ड स्टोरेज है नहीं, अगर ये मर गया यहाँ पर दस्तखत करें कि अगर ये मर गया तो उसको मसूंदर पे फेंकना पड़ेगा. माय फादर वाज ए स्ट्रांग यंग वाज टॉल वाज वेरी थिन बट वाज वेरी स्ट्रांग. यू नो इन द बाइबल यू सी यू हियर दैट जीसस क्राइस्ट सेड इफ यू हैव एन आई आउट ऑफ फेथ you will ask the mountains to move and they will move. I do not know whether this prophecy was fulfilled in the time of the Mosaic dispensation, but it was definitely fulfilled in the Mohammedan dispensation. He was a rock of determination, a rock of a trust in Allah Ta'ala. When the doctor said this, my father, I remember, said something like this. He said, "Where do I have to sign? If he dies, throw him into the sea." My mother started crying. My father assured her, "Amna Mubarak ko kuch nahi ho, no, don't worry, nothing will happen to him." And he held my hand and after signing, put me into the ship.
Narae Takbir! Narae Takbir! Hazrat Khatamul Anbiya! Mohsen-e-Insaniyat, Nara-e-Takbir.
My dear brothers, my dear daughters, you know, maut faut to insan ke haath mein hai, Allah Ta'ala ke haath mein hai. Kisi ko bula leta hai aaj, kisi ko kal bula lega. जाना तो हर एक ने है. दैट डॉक्टर सेड आई कुड नॉट सर्वाइव फॉर 7 days. आई नॉट ओनली सर्वाइव फॉर 7 days, आई नॉट ओनली सर्वाइव फॉर 7 years, बट बाई द ग्रेस ऑफ अल्लाह आई एम स्टैंडिंग बिफोर यू, आई हैव सर्वाइव मोर देन 70 years. After the doctor said that this boy cannot survive. This is the trust in Allah Ta'ala. And my father repeatedly said that Hazur has asked me to go there as soon as possible. And this is the matter when the battle, the World War has just ended. The World War has just ended in 1944, as you all know. So this was the determination. And this was a resolve. This was the obedience to Khilafat. And this is how our missionaries, countless missionaries, are working all over the world. I have many instances. Maulana Ahmed Khan Sahab Naseem, those of you who have been in Rabwa might remember that he used to have a jeep. And he used to travel in that jeep, it was a habit, very strong, tall person, and he used to put his foot out of the, door. And that is a very strong man indeed. Once a non-Ahmadi delegation came to Rabwa to debate about the ascension of Jesus Christ. Okay, Hazrat Chizal, asman pe baithe hain. The Ahmadis showed them many dozens of, almost a dozen. Ho gaya sabut ye 30 ayat se. Ibn Maryam mar gaya haqqi qasam. Dakhle jannat hua wo muhtaram. Phir kaha ke ho gaya ye sabut ye 30 ayat se. He showed him many ayat. He said, no, it's not conclusive. So they took him to Maulvi Ahmed Khan Sahib Naseem. Maulvi Ahmed Khan Sahib Naseem took a completely different view, and he told the people, those Christians, those people who had come, and those Muslims who had come, to say that Jesus Christ is not dead, he is alive, sitting on the right hand of God. And he told the other Muslims that you have come to debate with us, we have shown you countless arguments, but Ahmed Khan Sahib Naseem took a different view. He said there are nearly 25 names of prophet in the Holy Quran. Do you need the Quranic verses to prove that they are dead? If we cannot prove from the Holy Quran, do you consider that they are sitting at the right hand of God? Maulvi Sahib ne kaha ek aur bilkul ek aur zaviye se unko samjhaya ke dekhiye Quran Majeed mein to kareeban 25 anbiya ka zikr hai. क्या उनकी वफात, हर एक की वफात हम कुरान मजीद से साबित करें? और अगर साबित ना कर सकें तो इसका मतलब यह है कि आसमान पर बैठे हुए हैं. यू नो, यू प्रीच विद विजडम. एंड दे वर डंबफाउंडेड एंड दे सेड वी डू नॉट रिक्वायर. मौलाना गुलाम सुब राज्य की, यू एज आई हैव सेड अर्लियर, वॉज ए वेरी स्ट्रॉन्ग पर्सन. I have visited him in countless times, and we used to go and sit with him, and we used to talk with him. He has narrated many incidents. There is a big book. Rajik Sahib ke upar 5 jilde hain, huge book. And he said once I was traveling, and I had to cross the river Chenab, and it was high flood. And we were in a boat, and the boat was about to sink, and people started shouting the name of Al-Bukhari and other saints that will save us. Hazrat Maulvi Sahib told them to stop this, and he prayed to God that, oh Allah, if we are doomed to die, but I have some books of the promised Messiah. मेरे पास कुछ किताबें हैं हज़रत मसीह मौऊद अलैहिस्सलाम सल्लल्लाहु अलैहि वसल्लम की लिखी हुई. हम उन कुतुब को लेकर जा रहे हैं. तो कहते हैं कि एकदम जो है वो तूफान थम गया. और हम वहाँ पर पार कर गए और वो हमारे हम महफूज रहे. मौलवी साहब यू मस्ट हैव सीन दैट सी समटाइम ही यूज्ड टू व्हेन ही यूज्ड टू डिबेट समटाइम ही यूज्ड टू से दैट इफ यू इवन द पीपल कुड नॉट आंसर हिज क्वेश्चंस ही वुड से अगर जवाब नहीं दे सकते तो मेरे साथ कुश्ती कर लो, हदीस पे बात कर लो, कुरान मजीद पे बात कर लो, फारसी शायरी पे बात, हदीस किसी बात पे बात कर लो. और जब वो नहीं कर सकते थे, चुप बैठे थे, तो फिर कहते थे अच्छा फिर कुश्ती कर लो. जब फिर भी चुप करके बैठे थे कहते अच्छा फिर कलाई पकड़ लो. आई एम नरेटिंग दिस सो दैट अवर मिशनरीज अवर जमात शुड ऑल्सो बी अवेयर दैट वी शुड बी स्ट्रांग फिजिकली स्ट्रांग एज वेल. मौलाना अबुल लता जलंधरी साहिब, यू नो ही वॉज ए मिशनरी एंड ही वॉज पोस्टेड इन पैलेस्टाइन. वंस ही हैड ए डिबेट एंड द पीपल सेड ही हैज नॉट डाइड एंड व्हेन द पीपल हु हैड कम फॉर द डिबेट व्हेन दे बिकेम स्पीचलेस दे सेड ओके if he has not died, if he died a natural death, then show us where is his grave. Mawlana Sahib said, this is not the point. The point is he has died. I can't show you the graves of everybody. Show me the grave of Hazrat Nuh alayhi salam. But they not said, show us the grave. Where did he die? He said, he went from Palestine to Tibet and went to Afghanistan and went to Kashmir and he died in Kashmir and in Mahalla Khan Yar. His grave is there and there was a person sitting over there in one of the parts of the delegation and he said, how could he go so far? Hazrat Masih alayhi salam, itne dur kaise chale gaye? To ek Palestini Ahmadi baithe hue the saath hi, unhone foran keh diya कि कश्मीर दूर है कि आसमान दूर है. आप कहते हैं कि कश्मीर बहुत दूर है, वो कैसे वहाँ चले गए? तो आसमान नज़दीक है, जो आसमान पर जाके बैठे हुए हैं दाएं हाथ.
नारे तकबीर हजरत मोहम्मद मुस्तफा, इस्लाम अहमदियत, गुलाम अहमद की, गुलाम अहमद की. नारे
Maulvi Abul Lata Sahib, as you all know, was given the title of Khalid. Khalid bin Walid of Ahmadiyyat. Another Khalid, Malik Khalid Khadim Hussain Sahib. He was debating with somebody. And the person said, how can Mirza Ghulam Ahmad be the Mahdi? He should be the son of Abdullah. His father should be Abdullah. His name should be Muhammad. His mother's name should be Amina. Chaudhry Abdullah Khan sahab wahan baithe hue the. चौधरी अब्दुल्ला खान साहब के भाई चौधरी अब्दुल्ला साहब कहने लगे कि देखें भाई, मेरा नाम अब्दुल्ला है, मेरा एक बेटा है उसका नाम है मोहम्मद और उसकी माँ का नाम है आमिना. कुछ देर ठहर जाओ, ये बड़ा हो जाएगा तो इसको मान लो कि मेहदी. व्हाट इज दिस रिडिकुलस? बिकॉज दे सेड दिस. They said Mirza Ghulam Ahmad, his son was not Abdullah. And his mother was you say Chirag Bibi. His mother should be Amina. और जो सब बैठे हुए थे वहाँ पर उन्होंने कहा कि देखें थोड़ी देर इंतज़ार कर लें कि मेरे बेटा जो मोहम्मद है ना बड़ा हो जाए, क्योंकि मेरा नाम अब्दुल्ला है, मेरे बेटे का नाम मोहम्मद है और मेरी बीवी का नाम आमिना है. ये थोड़े से बड़ा हो जाए ना, फिर इसको मेहंदी मार लेना. दिस इज हाउ ही साइलेंस्ड दोज पीपल. आई विल नरेट अनदर एग्जाम्पल. आई हैव लिव्ड द बेटर पार्ट ऑफ माई लाइफ इन अफ्रीका इन सियेरा लियोन. The president of this, Maulana Khalil Mubashir Sahib, is also from Sierra Leone. We have both spent many long years. In Sierra Leone, there's a huge river called the River Seva. Bojibu ke saath. Near Bojibu. And there was a paramount chief called Chief Gasimu. कासिम नाम था तो उसको गासिमु कहा करते थे. एंड देयर वाज अ ह्यूज रिवर दैट वाज पासिंग. द जमात सेंट मेनी मिशनरीज बिकॉज इट इज अ कस्टम इन सियेरा लियोन इन अफ्रीका दैट इफ यू आर एबल टू कन्विंस द पैरामाउंट चीफ ए नंबर ऑफ पीपल कैन कम इनटू द कम्युनिटी. एंड सो ए नंबर ऑफ पीपल यू नो वेद वी सो दे वेंट एंड मेनी मिशनरीज वेंट ओवर देयर एंड ही डिड नॉट एक्सेप्ट. दे वर walking near the bank of the river and Chief Gasimu said, look, don't waste your time on me. If this river even starts running down upstream, you see this river running downstream, even if the river starts running upstream, I will never believe. Don't waste your time. The Jamaat sent an old missionary and he went over there and he preached to him. And this Chief Gasimu later wrote to our missionary. He said, sir, the river Seva has started flowing in the opposite direction. I have become an Ahmadi.
Through Narae Takbir! Narae Takbir! Islam Ahmadiyyat! Muslim Insaniyat! Hazrat Muhammad Mustafa! Narae Takbir!
Suriba Bangura sent an old missionary who did not have much education. You have to have a communion with Allah Ta'ala, a relationship with God the Almighty. Then your voice becomes heavy. It pierces through. It zeroes in to the target. This paramount chief wrote a letter to our missionary that, sir, the river has started flowing in the opposite direction. I have become an Ahmadi. And then in those days, in the early 50s, he contributed more than 1,000 British pounds for the opening of a press in Bo. 1,000 pounds in those days was a huge sum of money, maybe equivalent to 40,000 pounds in these times. And this is how he gave so much by the grace of Allah. I have My grandfather used to narrate. हमारे दादा जान उसको मियाँ जी कहा करते थे. बहुत दफ़ा उन्होंने सुनाया मुझे कि when our father was going for the first time to Africa, he lost his, you know, the luggage was booked in the luggage van, luggage train, and somehow the receipt was lost. And Molisa was to travel the next day by ship. And my Miyaji was telling my father every now and then, Nazir Ahmed, Bilti di receipt gum ho gayi hai. Saman kis tarah loge? I have lost the receipt. How will you get the luggage? Moli Sahib did not talk. Miaji said two or three times. Then Miaji used to say that Maulvi Nazir Ahmed confronted me and said, Miaji, if my luggage stands in my way, I will kick it into the sea. This is the level of devotion. This is the level of our Ahmadis. There was another man called Sheikh Haidaruddin. Sheikh Haidaruddin was a great scholar who was not only the Justice of Peace in Freetown, but he also received the member of the British Empire. A very powerful person, a very great scholar. When Maulvi Nazir Ahmed Sahib Ali went to Freetown in 1939, and there was a public meeting, and the meeting was held, and he was the chair. This Haidaruddin was the chair. And in his concluding remarks, instead of saying something good about the lecture which the Maulvi Sahib had given about the coming of Hazrat Masih Maud Alaihi Salatu Wasalam, he said, look, I have more knowledge than you all. This Indian Haji is a liar. The Mahdi and Messiah has not yet come. Don't fall into the trap of this false man and don't listen to his words. He said, instead of believing in this false Messiah, I would prefer that I become mad and I lose my senses so as to avoid listening to this man. That is what he said. A few months afterwards, Sheikh Haidaruddin Sahib lost his senses, became mad, became a lunatic. He was imprisoned in his own house. And after about 2 or 3 years, he died a miserable death. His own son, his only son, who opposed the Ahmadiyya Jamaat, he also died in his young, very young age. His grandson, only grandson, who also attended our Ahmadiyya's primary school, he misbehaved and tried to poison our missionary Maulvi Muhammad Siddiq Sahib, and he also died at a very young age. Allah Ta'ala wrapped down the entire family. Inna shaniyaka huwa labtar. The whole family was wiped down from this earth. In Ghana, there are no earthquakes. Very difficult. Very few earthquakes in Ghana. When Maulvi Nazir Ahmed Sahib Mubashshar was a missionary over there, he was preaching and he told them about the coming of Masih Maud. They said, well, the coming of Masih Maud, it should be preceded by an earthquake. So they did not listen to him. Maulvi Sahib said that I reclined to my place and I said, I begged to Allah Ta'ala that, oh Allah, you have sent the Messiah and you have sent the Mahdi and they are asking now for an earthquake. Wo zalzale ki khwahish kar rahe hain ki zalzala aayega to phir hum samjhenge. ایک ہفتہ نہیں گزرا تھا تو جمعہ اور ہفتہ کے اتوار کو شدید زلزلہ آیا گانا میں اس وقت اس کا نام گولڈ کوسٹ تھا اور وہ کہتے ہیں کہ اسی وقت 180 بندوں نے بیعت کر لی
نعرہ تکبیر حضرت محمد مصطفیٰ اسلام احمدیت نعرہ تکبیر
We have got a gigantic task. It's not our concern. The Ahmadiyya Jamaat is bound to prosper. It is bound to prevail. The pertinent question is, what is my share? What have I done? What is your contribution? That is the question. We are all, on a belt, and we're all going to our graves. if not today, tomorrow. What have we done? What have we achieved? That is the question. As far as the spread of the Ahmadiyya Jamaat is concerned, we are just concerned. Hazrat Masih Maud, jaise maine kaha na, likha hai, khaak sari ko hamari dekh, ae danaye raaz. Kaam tera kaam hai, hum ho gaye ab beqarar. Phir farmaya, ae mere pyare, fida ho tujh pe har zarra mera. Pher de meri taraf, ae sarban, yaki muhar. We should pray to Allah Ta'ala. Jo mustar ki dua hai, wo zarur qubul hoti hai. Amma yujibul mustarra idha dua'ahu fa yakshu'a an yajalu lukum khulafa'a khulafa' al-arz. Who answers the prayers of the distressed person? If we pray in distress, when we are really agitated, if we pray to Allah Ta'ala, they're all sitting over here, mostly from the Asian subcontinent, longing for that day when that prophecy of Hazrat Masih Maud alayhi salatu wasalam, that many nations will, every nation will drink of this fountain. So it's our duty that we should try and proclaim and present with wisdom the message of Ahmadiyyat. It is to be done with prayers. Our coat of arms is the prayer. Maulana Nayyar Sahib, you know, who was a missionary, and he went to Nigeria, and after a short while, a telegram was sent to Hazur, which was announced at Jalsa Salana, and the telegram was, please accept the bath of 10,000 people. Maulvi Nayyar Sahib also said that a missionary should have, he made sort of, they said, the seven P's of Nayyar. Nayyar ki saat alfaz hain, jo jinka P ke saat taluk hai, aur wo tabliq ke liye har muballigh ke paas honi chahiye. Phir uske baad is alfaz mein aur bhi izafa kiya gaya. Maulis Nazir Ahmed Sab Ali ne kiya, aur muballighe ne kiya. To wo unke naam main zara pad deta hoon aapko. One of them was prayer. Dua ke bagair ye kaam nahi ho sakta. Prayer. The second was that we should preach. This is the coat of arms of a missionary. And you are all missionaries. The second is piety. Agar taqwa nahi hai, har ek neki ki jad ye taqwa hai, agar ye jad nahi, sab kuch raha. Agar ye jad nahi, sab kuch raha. So piety. He said a missionary should have a close contact with the press. P, press. And then he said a missionary should take care of his passport. You know, muballigh ke baad agar passport na sahi ho. Phir usne kaha ki muballigh jo hai, he should have good contact with the police. P with police. And then he said also with the postmaster. Because otherwise your letters would not reach at the proper time. And then also he should have contact with the priest. Unke saath bhi taluq hone chahiye. A muballigh should be passionate. P for passionate. There should be perseverance. You should not lose hope. Once Sir Zafrullah Khan came to our Taleem al-Islam College and he gave a lecture, a 40-minute lecture, and the only subject was perseverance. You never lose hope. You fall once, you try again. You fall once, you try again. Don't give up. Perseverance. Then punctuality. If you are not punctual, we lost a very good Ahmadi who wanted to become an Ahmadi when he came to our mosque. The punctuality was not being observed. A missionary needs to be very punctual. And another was that he should be patient. He should show patience. Sabr ka saboot de. Aur in baaton se ghabraye na. Allah Ta'ala mujhe bhi aur aap sabko is baat ki taufeeq ata kare ki ye jo kaam hai, aaj bhi Hazur ka jo khutba tha, isi mauzu pe tha. we will continue to face opposition. The opposition is bound to come. But there's no opposition. You know what happened? People who oppose the Ahmadiyya Jamaat, you know what happened to them? They tried to destroy the Ahmadiyya Jamaat. You remember that video is on the phone where the six heads of state are sitting in line and they are planning that Ahmadiyyat should disappear from the face of the earth and should at least should be declared as non-Muslims. Look at what happened to Faisal. Look at what terrible happened to Gaddafi. Are there chances? What happened to all the others, Ziaul-Haq? What happened to all those people who were sitting over there? Is it chances? मुझसे हर एक ने वार वार किया अपने रंग में आखिर जलील हो गए अंजामे जंग में कहां मरते थे पर तू नहीं मारे May Allah Ta'ala bless us all and may we rise from this Jalsa Salana. May we benefit from the addresses of this Jalsa Salana. This is a very important gathering. We should go out from this Jalsa Salana and our level of communion with Allah Ta'ala, the level of our rendezvous with God the Almighty, the level of our union with God the Almighty, the level of our grafting with God the Almighty should be at a higher level. Otherwise, it's a waste of time. People have spent thousands and thousands of dollars in order to come and attend this Jalsa Salana. The Jamaat has spent a colossal amount for this Jalsa Salana. And if we just go out without benefiting from the scholarly speeches and we do not gain any higher level of taqwa, then we only have to blame ourselves. As they say, you can take a man, you can take a horse to the river, but you can't force it to drink. Jazakallah and Assalamu alaikum.
Nare Takbir! Nare Takbir! Hazrat Muhammad Mustafa! Ghulam Ahmad Ki! Ghulam Ahmad Ki! Jamaat Ahmad